Thank you. Testing, testing. This is Judith Abigail Susan James, the Crown Archaeological Expedition. We're starting out our investigation at the canyon. The main artifact is large, pyramid-shaped, and appears to have some sort of an entrance at the top. We'll start closer examination tomorrow after a good night's sleep. Very exciting. These stone tablets seem to tell some ancient legend, but it's as if the markings have been somehow scratched off. Our electronics equipment keeps malfunctioning near this site. Oh, and there's an eerie glow around the stone ring at night. No apparent source for the light, yet it glows. We'll need to come back to this later. I'm sure there's a way to restore these and read the legends. This is Judith Abigail Susan James, the Crown Archaeological Expedition.
The bringer of great knowledge, the one-armed king, descended to us from the skies. We welcomed the king to our tribe. We greeted him as one of our own.
Notes on the pyramid. Last night I swear I heard a cry for help inside the pyramid. Very creepy. The team got so anxious that we decided to play it safe and fill the structure with cyanide gas before attempting entry. The voices seem to have stopped now, so it was probably just some wildlife. Supplemental. We've waited for 2 days, but the gas is not evaporating for some reason. It's weird, but it's not the weirdest thing we've encountered on the island. We'll need to get the gas masks from our jungle camp if we're to enter. This is Judith Abigail Susan James, the Crown Archaeological Expedition. Well, the gas masks are gone. Apparently, the beachhead station took them during their last resupply mission. They also reported some strange phenomenon deeper in the jungle. Intriguing. We better head that way. We'll just take one detour to see the new artifact discovered at the Site B. This is Judith Abigail Susan James, the Crown Archaeological Expedition.